What's going on, you guys? It's your man James, aka JP, back again here at Magic Kingdom. Now, I've been here since 10 o'clock this morning. It's now about like 3 or 4 in the afternoon. I've been here all day, and I want to show you guys what Magic Kingdom is like, because it's absolutely mind-blowing. It is crazy. It is insane. It is completely empty here, and all the rides have been pretty much just walk right on, no waits whatsoever. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a quick tour of Magic Kingdom here at Walt Disney. So here is a look down Main Street, and this is something that you never see. It is empty. This is mind-blowing. If you guys have been to Disney, you know how busy Main Street gets. This is absolutely insane, and it's been like this pretty much the whole day. And there is Christina taking her selfies. But here is the money shot of the brand new castle, Cinderella's Castle, with the new paint job. It's okay. I don't hate it, but I don't love it. I just feel like, and we'll get closer here in a second, but I just feel like the combination of like the grays on the bottom with the rose gold at the top doesn't really work too well. But other than that, it looks really, really nice. But here is the hub. And I mean, this is just insane. I've never ever seen it this dead. Not at Mickey's Not So Scary or the Very Merry Christmas Party. It has never, ever once been this dead. All right, so here is the castle. Oh my gosh, you guys. So like I was saying, I don't feel like the grays really work well with the rose gold. But other than that, I think everything looks pretty nice. The gold trimming or little accents around is a little off-putting as well. But the color will fade over time with this Florida sun just beaming down on it. So I feel like that is why they painted it just so dark with the saturation with the blues and the pinks and whatnot. But overall, it is coming along very nicely. Still got a little ways to go. Not completely done, but we are almost there. Here is a shot of what it looks like walking into Liberty Square. And again, I mean, you're gonna hear me say this throughout the whole video. I've been saying it basically nonstop all day. It's just dead. It's so crazy how there's no people in front of you, no people in back of you. I mean, it's just insanity. So there is a shot of the entrance of Liberty Square. Hopefully, if we'll get lucky, we'll have a cavalcade roll past us. But here is what it looks like. So you can see they are still working on the castle right here. You can see the construction crane to paint that side right there. So we got a cavalcade coming towards us right now, I believe, or maybe not the cavalcade, but we do have the band right here. I'm not sure what exactly their name is, but we'll get a good shot of them rolling by right now. Pretty much has happened sporadically throughout the day. There's no set time for when they come by because they don't want people crowding around. So just randomly throughout the day, you'll see little mini parades or mini shows like that just kind of going through the park, which is really cool. It's a nice little surprise because you never know when it's coming. So here we are crossing over into Frontierland, and again, it is just empty out here. I mean, just crazy. You never ever see it like this. I've been here all day and my mind is still pretty much blown from all of this. It's just crazy. Looks like we have another little mini parade coming towards us, so let's go ahead and move to the side. I can't tell who it is from here, but as they approach, we'll get a better look at them. Looks like we have a 2-for-1 here, so not only is the parade coming towards us, but so is the ferry boat. So you see that right there. And then over here we have Gaston, and it looks like we have Alice, Peter Pan, and Winnie the Pooh. Oh, Mary Poppins and Tigger are following behind. Oh, there is Aladdin on the rear end. Here is Splash Mountain, possibly one of the last times we could be seeing it up and running. I don't know, I think it'll be a little while before it closes, but who knows what Disney has planned. Let's see if we can get somebody coming down. There we go. Such a fun ride. And actually, it's looking really, really good right now because is extremely, extremely hot out here.
You are required to wear your mask at all times unless you are at one of the designated rest areas where you can take your mask off, or if you have a food or beverage, I can't even speak. If you have a food or beverage in your hand, then you are allowed to take your mask off, sit back, relax, and get some water because, man, it is hot out here. My camera actually just overheated, so it looks like I am periodically gonna have to be letting the camera cool down as well as letting myself cool down as well. So gonna take a little refreshment here before we continue.
Here is how the characters socially distance meet and greets right here. So you see the country bears hanging out up here, waving hello, saying hi to everybody. Hey guys. So that is one way that you can have character interactions here, just at a distance. Give you guys an idea of what the wait times are like all throughout the park. You can see everything is 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, Splash Mountain being the longest at 25 minutes, which still is not bad at all. And most of these that say 5 or 10 or even 15 minutes, they're pretty much just a walk-on. I think the only thing we've waited for today was Splash Mountain. Everything else we pretty much walked right on, even Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, which is crazy. And right now that is at a 10-minute wait, which is insane. You never see that. So here is a closer look at the castle right underneath it as we're crossing over into Fantasyland through the middle of the castle. You can just see some of the details right here. So one thing that's really cool here is the bricks are actually numbered. I don't know if you guys can really make that out, but they're numbered by which shade of gray they need to be painted by, which is pretty, pretty cool. And here is the backside of the castle for anybody who wants to see an angle of that. Looks very, very nice. It actually looks a lot nicer on the backside to me than the front side. Love the gold accents on this side. It looks a little odd on the front side, but back here, it actually doesn't look too bad. Probably because there's not that much gray, that's probably why. And here we are in Fantasyland, and I mean, it speaks for itself. You can literally just walk anywhere you want. There's just so much room all around here. It's insane. And with the parks being so dead, it's just eerily quiet. Like, you can just hear everything. You can hear birds chirping, just sounds that you wouldn't normally hear because there's just so many people and such a big crowd that the noise from everybody talking and whatnot kind of distorts everything. But here, you just hear everything. It's insane. So just take a listen really quick, guys. Empty and just eerily quiet. It's the weirdest thing ever for a theme park. Let's see if I can get a shot of Mine Train as it rolls by. There should be a cart getting ready to come by any second now. There it goes. Gonna hop on Little Mermaid real quick. One, because it's the closest ride that we're passing, and two, because we haven't actually rode it yet. But I do want to show you guys some of the social distancing measures that they got going on, all the hand sanitizing stations. I'm sure you guys have noticed as we've been walking around all the markers on the floor and whatnot, but I do want to show you guys how the rides actually operate because it's pretty simple and straightforward. But here we go, 5 minute wait, which probably means we're gonna walk right on. So here is the first hand sanitizing station. There we go, boom, got the hand sanitizer. And then as you can see all throughout the queue, you obviously have the markers. Very simple, very straightforward. Stand where the closest marker is to you. But in this case, I don't think we're gonna be standing at all. I have a feeling we're just walking straight on. But as you can see, there you go. And I wouldn't be surprised if there is another hand sanitizing station as we get closer to the entrance. They're just scattered all throughout the park, which is crazy. That water looks really good right now. There is another hand sanitizing station right by the entrance. So like I said, that's two hand sanitizing stations before we even get onto the ride.
Boys, oh, wait for me. Wait a minute, you look kind of familiar. Well, anyway, Ariel fell in love with a human. Then King Triton got all mad and caused the Mankey to grab the watch over.
Thank you.
another hand sanitizing station as we get off of the ride. So a lot of hand sanitizing stations all around, which is very, very nice. In typical Florida weather, nice, bright, beautiful, clear skies in front of us. And then behind us, bad black thunderstorm heading this way. But it's always so funny to see this and then just turn and see that. Here we are entering into Tomorrowland. And again, very repetitive, I know, but I cannot just express how much, like, how empty it actually is. It's really, like, I've been here since 10 a.m. It's now like 4 p.m. and I'm still at a loss for words. It is absolutely mind-boggling just how empty it is, how much space there is, how much you can hear, how many more things you notice that it's not just flooded with people everywhere. It's honestly really, really cool. If it wasn't for this storm, we would hop on Buzz Lightyear's Star Command, or what is it? Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin. But because of the storm, we're trying to beat it. So we're actually heading to the car now. So I think that's gonna do it for us. So I'm just gonna film this outro really quickly. Hopefully we make it back to the car before
it rains. So hopefully you can hear me because it is windy. If not, I'll film another outro somewhere else. But overall, I mean, this could not have gone any better. There is no waits for anything whatsoever. Everything feels pretty safe. I will say though, Universal and Islands of Adventure, they force you to put hand sanitizer on before you get on every ride. They forcibly put it in your hands. And here they have the stations. So it is recommended, but it's not necessary that you do it before you get on the ride like Universal or Islands. That's the only thing, but it's really not big of a deal because I still get the hand sanitizer before and after getting on every ride. But overall, I mean, short waits, you really can't beat it. If you're a Florida resident, now is the time to come. Like I said, everything 5, 10, 15 minute waits, or pretty much just walk right on. So that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Share this video with your friends. Be sure to follow me on Instagram and make sure you have those notifications clicked on because I will be vlogging all week for the next 4 days here at Walt Disney World. Tomorrow, we're going to Hollywood Studios. So that's pretty much it. Stay tuned for more, and as always, I'll see you guys next time.